of Former Commission on Human Rights Chief Etta Rosales. Good morning to you, ma'am.
Yeah, good morning, Karen.
All right, first, were you shocked? This came as a surprise, frankly, even my sources tell me, to members of the Defense Department.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, of course. Because this has been going on since 1989. How long ago was that? So many years ago, actually, people are used to the idea that there must be some kind of an understanding Mm-mm. between the security forces and the schools themselves if there's going to be any activity by the security forces. And so this has become traditional already since Mm-mm. 1989. That is why everybody was surprised. Nagulat kami, bakit magkakaroon na ganito? Yun.
Okay, there's been much debate if Malacanang can do this unilaterally when the truth is they just did. You know, they just did it.
Yeah, they just did it.
Yeah.
And that's dangerous. Mm. That's dangerous because it's very arbitrary and deliberate, and it has a shameless disregard for the rule of law. And
okay.
When we speak of the rule of law, we're talking about the Constitution. Yeah.
But what then is the solution? For example, this is an accord by essentially two entities, right? It doesn't go above the Constitution. The agencies can argue that times have changed and we feel differently. What recourse does UP have?
Then UP has to continue asserting for the dialogue with the security forces. You can't, as pointed out by the lawyers, there is no exit clause. So you cannot unilaterally terminate an agreement that has been agreed upon by two parties, two entities. It has to take the two of them to decide now to terminate the agreement if they want to. Mm-mm. So I think what UP can do is to, you know, insist on a dialogue with Secretary Lorenzana and get him to reconsider. It's arbitrary. You know, he said that this is only out of my own volition. Mm. It has nothing at all to do with the president. Well, tell that to the Marines. Mm. Everybody knows that Mr. Duterte was the one that was insisting that, you know, there's a recruitment program going on in UP, and therefore every member, the members of the students are actually endangered of being forced to join the New People's Army or the CPP, which is, wala namang ebidensya nun, di ba?
Okay, now, but let's take the argument of the Defense Department. Couldn't it be true? The argument of Secretary Lorenzana is, this is meant to protect the students. You have students that have died. They were caught in the crossfire. What about his argument on that?
I don't think that it is the defense secretary and the security forces to protect the students against what they feel is, you know, the dangers of joining the New People's Army or the CPP. There is academic freedom inside the university. The students can exercise the right to think of Marxist ideas. If this is something that I feel is interesting and instructive, they can even study about communism. Mm. That is part and parcel of, you know, academic freedom. Mm-hmm. And they should not be deprived that, especially by the security forces, who have a lot of learning to do with respect to what security is all about from a human rights point of view, and from the rule of law perspective. Mm.
Okay, this is a very interesting point that you just made. Yesterday, I interviewed Senator Ping Lacson, and he said, joining protests is one thing, but bearing arms against the government is another. It's a crime. Do you
exactly.
agree with that?
So yes, of course.
If you do, then that is the point of Secretary Lorenzana. It's not about studying about these Marxist ideas or leftist ideas. His point is being recruited to to join the armed group of the CPP-NPA and students dying because they've been part of the crossfire, the encounter?
Does he have evidence of that? Does he have evidence of recruitment going on in UP with the NPAs there joining and going through the whole process? So, yun yun eh. Hindi pwede yung opinion, hindi pwede yung mga arbitrary thinking lamang. Kasi merong former members of the CPP, former members of the NPA na nasa gobyerno na ngayon na nagsasalita, hindi yun yung ebidensya na kinakailangan.
Oo. Now, Eta, are you satisfied with the response of the UP faculty and the UP management?
Yeah, I think that the management and the president himself have actually expressed their position asserting academic freedom from UP. But I would probably suggest that the president of the University of the Philippines, push further, assert. For a dialogue with the Secretary of Defense, Lorenzana. Alam mo, si Secretary of Defense, Lorenzana, hindi naman ganyan dati, I remember. You know, he sounds very open and liberal. So why is he behaving this way right now? I can only suspect that it is the Duterte administration that is pushing for this. Because, Karen, their framework is the anti-terror law.
Yeah. Exactly.
So, in press freedom has been challenged. We don't have to go through that. Maria Ressa again was being arrested, for the nth time, and so she had to again ask for bail, pay money for bail, and then again, ABS-CBN. What has happened to ABS-CBN? So that's press freedom. Then. Next is academic freedom. Isa-isa yan eh.
Now, the larger picture is the dwindling, they say, the dwindling democratic space in the Philippines. That's the larger picture of this whole scenario.
Yeah, it's shrinking.
Some may say, oh, that's pushing it a bit too far. I just have it on my phone, some members of the cabinet saying academic freedom was not affected, freedom of speech was not affected, Karen. So you have that argument too.
No. Ang daming nagsasalita. We must start from the premise of on the ground, of the reality on the ground. First of all, what was that accord all about? That accord was a product of a consensus between both parties that we must be responsible, we must be the watchdogs to ensure that there is peace and order and stability, the rights of the academic actors within the university are respected, etc., etc. So that is what we start, that is the starting point. So why do you unilaterally terminate a consensus, an agreement that enhances democratic rule, that upholds the rule of law and the constitutional provisions for stability? Basically, I think there is a consensus that you need to have peace, order, stability in order for us to be able to develop. Diba? In order for us to address the, pandemic that is very urgent and very immediate, the economy, and so on and so forth. Kailangan merong kapayapaan.
Now, do you see this also as a deflection? Considering we are in the midst of a pandemic, in the midst of purchasing vaccines, in the midst of asking for programs on the vaccination rollout, there is nothing that came out in the news you know, about a student being recruited to join the NPA last week, and yet here it's staring us in the face.
Yeah, parang, you know, some quarters suspect it's a diversionary tactic, which is typically used by governments, including this government, when it is in crisis, when it is being accused of overpricing. You know, that is the crucial question right now. The overpricing of vaccines. Mm-mm. And the non-disclosure of the different prices, so that democratically the representatives of the people, namely Congress, can look into the matter and decide what is the best vaccination product that should be bought. That is correct, fairly priced, and that will be beneficial for the people. That is the main question that is being discussed right now. Then all of a sudden, there is this arbitrary termination of the agreement. So ika naman, diversionary tactic yan para mawala na naman yung ating mga position, ang ating focus doon sa overpricing na nangyayari. You know, I think, di ba, alam mo, Karen, the Senate did a good job in looking into the ill health.
Yeah. Okay. Moving on. Eta, I wanted to ask you, the presence of military officers inside UP, let's say with the anti-terror law now being implemented, and hypothetically if a student is arrested, no, based on the anti-terror law or a suspicion of it or a designation of it, ang tanong ko, is the presence of military officers alone a violation of the right of the student? Is that a violation of a human right?
Yes, of course. The military has no business being in an academic community. The military belongs to the barracks. But the military belongs to the field where it has to do its duties. It has no business being in an academic community because it has no role to play in an academic community. The security guards are there to protect and to provide the peace and order necessary for the community.
Now, what do you see as the long-term effect of such actions? I mean, clearly it seems that Malacanang right now is asserting its power. But just like any other administration who's tried, history will also teach us that the results eventually come out differently in time. So what is the overall effect of this?
It is a process of continuing process of establishing authoritarian rule and undermining the democratic principles, which are precisely what are upheld and treasured by the people in the Philippine Constitution. It is establishing authoritarian rule because Mr. Duterte and his people believe that governance is best managed under an authoritarian climate and under an authoritarian structure. That is basic. And that is what the anti-terror law is all about. It is a continuing struggle, Karen, since time immemorial.
Yeah. Now, I know there are still petitions in the Supreme Court regarding the anti-terror law, but do you see this, the termination of the accord, going to the Supreme Court anytime soon?
I would think so. I would think that if the defense secretary refuses to engage in dialogue with the UP president, then maybe it is time that we petition the Supreme Court regarding the matter. In other words, Karen, I think that vigilance and commitment and continuing struggle must always be there. We should never let down, you know, let go of our guard. We should always be vigilant because that is the only way to overcome this encroachment that is taking place. And you know something, Karen?
Okay.
The Filipino people are democratic by nature. Matagal na yan eh. Eh, panahon pa ni Bonifacio, pinaniniwalaan na natin yan. So, ipagpatuloy natin.
All right. Yes. On that note, Ma'am Etta Rosales, I want to thank you so much for your time this morning. And you take care of yourself. Stay strong.
Thank you. Thank you. You too.